Hello everybody, in this video I will show you that how I have added the swing functionality so our player can be swing on the rope. Okay, so this is the player controller script and we have public pool jump false and we will call this variable in another script as well, and we have facing right equal to true as well. But before this script it was a private variable and I just converted it to public so that we can access it in another script. Okay, so now we will move to our script which I have created for the specific functionality of swinging, and here you can see that we have included Unity standard assets and cross platform inputs. After that we have created some variables, public float, swing force. You can increase and decrease it, public float delay before second hang, so we can add some time duration here, so after that much time our player can hang to another rope. Private static transform, and these are the private variables which are used inside the script, so don't be worried about these. So private static transform collided chain, static list transform chains for getting the chains, and then we have created a private transform player transform, we are getting the player position, and for we have added chain index, we have added collider 2D colliders, we also have created we get the player controller script in this script. Okay, so for that we have added private player controller and we named it P control, and whenever we will use the P control in our script that will be implemented. And for this we don't need animator, actually we can definitely use some animations as well if we want for a hanging rope. So after that we have created a private bool on rope, and if we are on rope or not, so initially we are not on rope, so that's why we baked it false. After that we also have created a timer for 0 seconds, and we have created a direction as well. We also created another variable direction x which is created inside this script as well. You can see that this variable, actually this one, we have created in this script as well. Okay, so for moving right and left, because we are using touch controls, that buttons. After that we have created start function and we called player transform position. Also we have initiated the colliders. Also we have initiated this script of our player controller. After that in update function we have written that if we are on rope then what will happen. Here we will say player.transform.position should be equal to collided chain.position. So when our player will collide with our chain object, our player will become a sub object of that chain object. Okay, also we have stable the rotation here, player transform dot local rotation equal to quaternion dot angle axis direction multiplied by 90, so 90 will be the vertical. Okay, so we want to place our player vertically, so that's why we are adding here 90 vector 3 dot forward, and actually here we can use 0. Okay, we want to make it it will be forward here. After that we have created a function for jump that if we are on rope, okay, then if we press jump button, okay, and we are getting cross platform inputs and we are getting jump function, then what will happen. So then we have said that it should run a coroutine of jump off, and also it should run p control dot jump true. So what happened that when we will collide with our rope, our player controller will be disabled. okay? And then after, when we jump from the robe, then our player controller will be enabled again, okay? So here you can see we have assigned a variable direction x for horizontal axis, and we said that if direction x is greater than direction x and not p control dot facing right, if our player is not facing right, then we want to flip our player, okay? So this will add another function that when we are on rope, we can move right side and our player will see towards right side. If we press the left arrow key, it will be left button, it will be flipped towards the left side, okay? So for that functionality we have added this, and you can add or not, it's up to you, it's your own choice. So after that we have added a force, and we are forcing vector 2 dot right towards right into direction x into swing force, and yeah, that's fine. So what we are doing that when we click on the when we press horizontal buttons, it should move towards that side, and it will apply a force, swing force towards that side. Okay, here we are creating a coroutine function jump off, and here we are saying that get component, we are resetting the velocity. So when we will click on again on jump button, what will happen, it will make our velocity zero again, okay, and it will reset the velocity, and then our player transform dot parent is equal to null. So we are detaching player from the chain. Also on rope equal to false, so now we are not on rope anymore, and our player controller will be enabled again, okay. After that we are waiting for some seconds before second hang, and this is assigned initially as here 0.4 seconds, so you can definitely manipulate it as per your need. Here again we will select all the colliders of the player and we will enable it again, okay. So now here you can see that I enumerator on Coolean Inter 2D. And now what are we doing here, that we are getting that if our player strike with robe, if it collides with robe collider, then what will happen, we are making our player as a child of the that robe game object. Okay, hopefully you understand the logics, and it was quite lengthy, so that's why I just wrote this before showing you and before implementing the before implementing the application, so implementing the script, sorry. So now I will just delete that animator, we don't need it at all. Also you can see if not p control dot grounded and collider game object dot tag equal to rope 2d, then we have to do this thing, okay. So that's it, it will not create any problem, I think so. Let's see what will happen in Unity. So on the player guy we have added this script rope control here, and that's it. We will only create we will only add script on the player itself. Then you can see this is the error because we just have deleted the grounded variable from the player controller script, and actually we can just delete this thing, we don't need it at all. And here you can see that if Coolean game object dot tag is equal to rope 2d, okay, so we are using rope 2d tag. So here inside the Unity, if you will select the chain, I just have added the tags for all the links rope2d. Okay, so it will be connected with this rope. So let's see what will happen. So now you can see no error is coming, so we can play the game and hopefully we will be connected with our rope. Let's see. So yeah, you can see we are swinging on the rope and we can apply the force as well. If we click here, you can see we can apply force to our rope. And if we click on this, you can see our player becomes flipped towards other side. Okay, so that's it for this video. And when we jump, you can see we just leave the rope. Okay, so in this video we just have created the rope functionality, and now our player is can connect with our rope and he can hang here and there. That's it for this video. Hopefully you understand this logic, and in next video we will move further. Goodbye.